Hari Bol, and welcome to Lesson 19 of Basic Mridanga Instruction. Now today I'm going to go over one of my favorite rhythms. Even though it's more or less basic, it's still one of my favorite rhythms to use in kirtan. And even though it's not too complex to play, when you play it right, it sounds like extremely, for lack of a better term, groovy. It just, you get the kirtan into a groove and it just stays rock solid if you play it right. A lot of people, experts, play this rhythm as well, and I'd like to introduce this to you because it's heard all over the place. This rhythm that I'm going to show you is used very often in Vrindavan style kirtans. In Aindra's day it was used a lot, and even now in Vrindavan and other places this kind of rhythm is used very often. So, to begin with, this is a bhajani style mantra. Okay, so it's 8 beats long. And so the first half is going to be 4, the second half is 4. The mantra is dhage ge ta ge ta ke ke ta ke. Now, I said that in rhythm, and I'll repeat that one more time. Dhage ge ta ge ta ke ke ta ke. It's very simple. So let's go to the first half. Da ge ge da ge. Alright. So the common thing here is it's going to be da da. Da ge ge da ge. Again, da ge ge da ge. The second half is da ke ke da ke. So the first half. Second half. That's all it is. So let's go ahead and practice it a little bit slowly, but then we'll speed up. Da ke ke da ke da ke ke da ke da ke ke da ke da ke ke da ke. Okay, now the reason it sounds good even when it's simple is because it has that rock solid rhythm of downbeats, every other downbeat on the right side, da, 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 da. And the other side is just very solidly keeping this. So it sounds weird on its own, each side on its own, but together it really makes it like a wonderful solid rhythm. Now, to solidify it even further, in the second half you can start off with ka instead of da. So instead of just this da, you can do both sides together. It intensifies it a little bit. So da ke ke da ke da. So, where is this used? That's the fun part. This is used in any lengthy type of kirtan, where you go from, so usually short kirtans go from like a slow to a fast portion. Usually there isn't that intermediate long medium portion, but in a long kirtan, say half hour or hour long or however long you get to do this, there may be an opportunity for you to go from a slow part to a medium part to a fast part where you kind of just get everybody jumping and dancing and that's the end of it. This medium portion where you're kind of grooving for a while, that's where you use this mantra. So I'll give you an example. It's used often when the singer does an alap. An alap is when they do an extended like vocalization, where they're singing for a while and the audience and the band members are playing and they get to kind of do their thing and then you get back to the kirtan. This is especially effective if you have two or more mridanga players playing this exactly the same. So I'll give you an example just in a regular kirtan. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna. So you can see how this mantra is effective for generating a solid rhythm as well as interest and excitement even during these very long, drawn-out styles of mantras. It's also very effective for when you want to transition into a half, a half-time or subdivide the mantra. So I'll give you an example of what that sounds like. In some circles, they call this a breakdown or a transition. Anyway, kind of interchangeable terms. I'll give you an example just to show what it looks like. Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. So you can use this for those extended long kirtans, but then try to use it smartly with those other transitional parts. What I transitioned to is another mantra you already know. That's all it was. It's tage kitagege, tage kitagege. So that mantra is actually one of the first two or three lessons in this series. But I just showed an example of how you can transition from a mantra that's twice as long into a mantra that's that length. So and that's sort of how you can use this mantra to go between the two and really get into the mantra, really groove it. By groove I mean, you know, a solid foundation rhythm where, you know, the tempo isn't moving. It's staying steady for a long time so that everybody can get into that meditative trance of these long kirtans. So it's especially effective. I encourage you to practice with a friend or a partner to play this mantra together to get it synchronized. It really is very much more effective that way. So I hope that this helps. Please try to use this in a medium portion of a kirtan and see how it goes. Now, before I sign off here, I'll just introduce a few variations of this tala that you might be interested in hearing and you might have heard before. Time, what's solid is every the underpinning, the undercurrent below, all of that was. That solid, groovy rhythm. So try to use this in your kirtan, and I hope that you find it really enhances the experience. Thank you very much. Hare Krishna.